Story number 7, the top two stories that made it to the meter this week: kids, mental health, and parents. There has been a lot of talk about ADHD, medications, kids growing up with disabilities, and I found a way to find the bright side of this story, and that's why it's in the top two stories this week, because people are often hard on just kids, and I think in reality, kids teach us a lesson about ourselves as adults. I was once a kid or once a child, so that's why I try to always look back, and I try to look at the story for what it is, and it's the fact that they're trying to get our attention. We even looked, I saw the story of the girl Greta, how she's on the front lines for climate change activists, and years from now, some people say she may regret some of the decisions that she's making, or her parents are letting her make. But the reason why this story crept in is because when adults often label kids with mental disorders, they may find out some things later on in life about their child that they didn't know about themselves. There's some stories that surfaced in. A Florida woman drives her car into a tree after telling four of her kids to remove their seat belts. Now, the thing that made this story interesting, and the reason why mental health is important, the reason why it's a hot topic, is because she told her kids that the devil couldn't hurt them. Now, I don't know where the reporter got this information or how this information surfaced, but this is actually a report that says a woman told her children that when they got in a car accident, and I guess they must have got this information from the kids. Now, this is scary stuff, because if you talk to a lot of psychologists, they will tell you that a lot of people think they're being chased by the devil. A lot of people think they're hearing voices. I even had my own case years ago when I was in the military. I was overworked, overexhausted, wasn't eating right, and I started drifting. And this is what happens. Some people become overstressed, overwhelmed with life. They may watch episodes. Some people become desensitized to what they're seeing on video games, what they're seeing in programs. And that's why this story is in the top two, because we cannot forget about our own mental health, our own veterans, people who have been in combat positions. Sometimes people don't want to seek help, and they don't think that something is wrong with them. An Arizona man allegedly kills his son, 6 years old, after holding him under hot water to exorcise. He said he was committing an exorcism on a demon. So you look at this, and where is it coming from? You know, a story like this is very scary, because we're looking at a lot of rules of thoughts. Some people, I often make jokes, because I come from a Christian environment. I was raised in a church, so I often joke about demons and people being possessed. I may joke, but some people take these things very, very seriously. They disown their family because of maybe a religious moral code of conduct. Now, there's nothing wrong with the fun and games, or understanding that even the people in the Bible days, or in the Quran, or in any religious text, they were confused with life as well. But some people do feel that people are evil or possessed, but they fail to realize the science of the matter. And that's why we see these worlds constantly colliding. And that's why psychology cannot possibly keep up with the human mind and the way we think. I'm using the correct way to explain this, because you may not understand what is happening. And that's why I try to do my research on these topics to give you the information that you need in this program. Is because when people see things happening on a mental scale, they get afraid and they think that something's wrong with them. When I was a kid, some things I couldn't explain. So being raised in this church, I would explain them as being either evil or demonic. And it may confuse some people in the academic field. But the fact is that when you see somebody beating somebody up, or you see people in a crowd getting all revved up and and pumping their chest, beating some girl or some male to the ground, you can't help but to think that, hey, something is wrong here. And then you read the Bible, you read a certain religious text, and it tells you about certain types of spirits. This is why story number 7 is here, and this is why it will remain a hot topic, because kids, parents, everybody battles with mental health issues. It's not just your average day-to-day person. Everybody battles with this, and some people are just afraid to talk about it. A former nurse pleads guilty to abusing 9 infants, leaving them with broken hands, broken legs, broken ribs. You when you look at this and you see what is actually happening, was this nurse overexhausted? Was she just going through something? This is why mental health is a big thing, and this is why if you have problems, it's okay to seek help. If you're falling into depression, it's okay to find somebody to talk to. You're not alone. You know, these things need to be discussed. Closed mouths do not get fed. Florida boy, 15, dead while protecting his sister from a home invasion. Suspected arrest. I guess the suspect was arrested with several stab wounds. So this 15-year-old kid probably will be traumatized. He's had to protect his 5-year-old sister from a home invasion. This is why mental health is an important thing. Pediatricians stand by. They're standing by meds for ADHD, but some say therapy could come first. This is why story number 7 is in the top 2 stories. It's a very important story. It homes in on what is actually happening in reality and why some parents are afraid or get afraid to let their kids go out into what I always joke or say is a jungle. But we all have different ways of living, different fashions. I'm not saying religion is wrong. I'm not saying science is wrong. I'm saying that everybody comes from different walks of life, and we all have different ways of interpreting things. But sometimes we all just need to sit back, relax, take a break from maybe what we're doing or maybe taking too seriously, and look at the big picture. Relax. It's a big world. You see some of these radicals, some of these people taking matters into their own hands, killing other people's children. It's very scary how big this world can be and how complex the brain is and how some people just snap. Only people I think that deserve to be looked at or think to deserve to be punished for their doings are the people who are actually doing harm to other people on purpose, deliberately, and they think and they're getting satisfaction out of it. Other than that, story number 7, that's why it's in the top 2, because it's an important story, and it will get you thinking, and it will get you to understand that in this world, there are some people that just need a little bit more tender love and care, and may need to step back from the room just a little bit, and just may need to just a little bit more attention on some matters, and may not need that weapon, or may not need to be left alone. These are may just need somebody to talk to. This story number 7, it goes in all angles and all directions, but it will continue to remain a hot topic, especially when suicides are up and people are wondering why people are killing mass amounts of innocent people for no apparent reason. Story number 7 will stay at the top 8 for weeks to come. I could probably promise you that. You're the me, and it'll be Brian Westward. It's my duty to get in the mirror every week, telling myself that I can do this. I can get on this show. I could talk. I can do this for the greater good of the public. Encouraging myself, giving myself the confidence I need to be all I can be, and to look at my own faults, look at my own problems, and find an avenue for you yourself to be informed. So if you want to contribute in any way, just kidding, all you have to do is visit www.method8inc.com, method80.com, where you can buy something, click on something, watch something, read something, or just sponsor a program. Every little bit counts. If you want to check out the stories that did make it in or almost made it, you want to do your own research, you may have your own program, your own news program, your own discussion forum, and you can check out the website. You can go on there, check out our archives of shows, things that we've done, skits, all types of things, all on the website. And if you want to help out, that's how I always tell you that I'm just a mediator standing in the middle. News, the news journalists, the people on the front lines, those are the ones who deserve all the credit. I just navigate the news for you. So if you want to help out my cause or contribute in any way, method, the number 8, inc.com, methodad.com. You can buy something, click on something, watch something, read something, or just sponsor a program. Every credit will count.
Have no fear, fellow citizens.